Welcome sa sipnain.com. This video, i-formalize na natin yung pinag-aralan natin sa pre-calculus 1.45 tsaka sa 1.46. No? Sa 1.45 tsaka sa 1.46, hanapin nyo yung video nyo yun. Pag hindi nyo naintindihan ng video na to, hanapin nyo yung dalawang videos na yun. Pre-calculus 1.45 tsaka pre-calculus 1.46. No? In case you didn't understand this video. Oops. Okay, so dito sa video na ito, pag-aaralan natin kung ano ba yung formal definition ng increasing, decreasing, tsaka constant values of functions. Sorry, constant parts of functions given an interval. No? So, increasing, decreasing, or constant. Ano ba ibig sabihin pag-increasing ang isang function on a particular interval? So here we have, suppose f is a function defined on an interval I. So the interval I is the, yung katulad sa previous video natin, ano ba yung interval na gusto mong tignan? So from, for example, from here, from negative 5 to negative 3, increasing siya. Kasi kung buong part ng function siya, for example, this whole function, may part siya na increasing, may part siya na decreasing, tsaka may part siya na constant. So, alin lang ba yung gusto mong tignan? Yun yung interval. Kung gusto kong tignan lang ay negative 5 to negative 3, then my function is increasing, no? Na-discuss na natin yun sa previous video, kaya hindi ko na yan ulitin dito. So, if you want to examine a function, you have to have your interval. For example, here, ang interval ko ay from here, ang interval ko ay x values, di ba? So, from here, kung ano yung x-coordinate nito, tsaka kung ano yung x-coordinate nito. Yan yung may interval. Interval ko na i. It doesn't matter what it is, no? Basta yun yung ibig sabihin ng interval. So, first, the function is increasing on I if and only if f of a is less than f of b for all real numbers a and b in I with a less than b. Now, medyo komplikado yung definition, pero ano ba ibig sabihin nun? Yung a and b, yun yung ating x-coordinates, di ba? So, ang condition natin dito is a is less than b. Pag nasa number line ka, pag less than yung isang number sa isang number, for example, a is less than b, then a must be on the left of b sa number line, di ba? Sa number line, kung sino yung nasa kanan, siya yung mas malaki. So, tama, nasa-satisfy natin yung condition. Mas maliit yung a, so nasa kaliwa siya. Dito pa lang tayo sa increasing, ha? Tapos, anong relationship dapat ng f of a tsaka f of b? No? So, dito, ano nangyayari sa f of a tsaka f of b? F of a mo to, sorry, f of b, yung katapat ng b syempre, tsaka yung f of a mo. Ano napapansin nyo dito? Sinong mas malaki? Here, we have a is less than b. Tsaka f of a is less than f of b. Sa y naman, kung sino nasa baba, syempre yun ang mas maliit. So, mas maliit yung f of a tsaka kaysa sa f of b. So, alin ba yan? Increasing, decreasing, or constant? Nandito siya, no? Sa increasing. This is an increasing function. No, yung A and B na yan, ano yan, arbitrary. Ibig sabihin, you can choose another two points here. For example, isang point, isang A dito, may A ka dito, saka may B ka dito. Importante, ganito yung condition mo, A is less than B. Meaning, the function is increasing on that interval if for any A, B in I, you can choose any A and B here with this condition, and this condition is always true. So, for example, my A is here. Ibang kulay tayo. For example, my A is here. As long as ano siya, nasa-satisfy yung condition na A is less than B, then still, my f of A is still less than f of B. So, you can choose any two two pairs, no, of numbers a and b such that a is less than b, and palagi ito magiging true. F of a is less than f of b. Now, tignan natin itong susunod na function. Ganito pa rin, a is less than b pa rin. Tignan natin kung pareho ba f of a is less than f of b pa rin, or mag-iiba na siya. So, for example, I have my b here. This is still part of the function, right? So, gusto ko dito yung b sa dulo. This is my b. And I choose a, of course, na nasa left ng b, no? Question, pwede pa ako dito? Hindi, no? Kasi yung interval ko lang is from here to here. So, wala akong tatamaan dito. Wala akong function dyan, no? Or hindi siya part ng interval I ko. Well, unless you define, of course. So, this is my a. And look at what happens to my f of b and f of a. Asan yung f of a ko? Siyempre, yung tinamaan ng a ko, yun yung f of a ko, di ba? And my b, and this is f of b. So, still, my condition is that a is less than b. But, what is the relationship between f of a tsaka f of b? Less than pa rin ba ang f of a? Sinong nasa taas? Yung f of a, di ba? So, mas malaki siya. F of a is greater than f of b. So, ito ay decreasing. Pag if a is less than b, but f of a is greater than b. Again, a and b are on the interval. No? The given interval yan. Kasi pwedeng pag lumabas ng interval, may iba na siya, di ba? So, alin ba yung tinitignan mo dun sa function? Yung nasa interval mo lang. Pili ka lang na interval mo. Or usually, sa mga test, or sa mga exercises sa libro, syempre, merong given interval. Okay? So, ganun din dito. You can choose any A or B, provided na A is less than B. And you will see that F of A is always less than F of B. If the function is increasing, sorry, the function is decreasing from or on the given interval. So let's have our constant. This is a constant function on a particular interval. So this is a is less than b, but f of a is greater than f of. This is increasing. No? This is increasing. And this is decreasing. This is still my interval here. And I choose A. Walang restriction, no? So, I can choose anywhere. A and B. And my F of A. Anli ng F of A ko? Ito rin yan, di ba? Kasi nandito yung point ko eh. So, asan din yung F of B ko? Nandito rin. Still f of b. So, also here. Si horizontal line nga siya. No? So, lahat ng y values mo pareho. So, for any a, b on the interval, no, your f of a is always equal to f of b. So, constant ang isang function on that interval. Okay, so I hope hindi ko nagulo yung inyong mundo, no? sa video na to. I hope meron kayo natutunan. Don't worry kung hindi nyo siya masyadong maintindihan. Ulit-ulitin nyo lang panoorin yung videos. Pag hindi nyo ito naintindihan, again, you come back to Precalculus 1.45 and Precalculus 1.46. Maraming salamat. See you in the next tutorial.